हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कोले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, शिवाजी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कन्नड़, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल स्टडी सम बेसिक रूल्स ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी। रूल ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी इज एडिटिव रूल ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी। इट इज एप्लीकेबल टू म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव इवेंट्स। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव इवेंट्स? फ्रेंड्स, अकरेंस ऑफ एनी वन इवेंट prevents occurrence of other. Means if one event is occurring, then at the same time another event will not occur. So we will see example. If we toss a coin, either head will come up or tail will come up. Head and tail will not come up together at the same instant. These events of head and tail are called as mutually exclusive events. In figure A, a box of volume V is shown. In this box, two small overlapping regions, delta V1 and delta V2, are shown. Particle cannot be present at the same time in both the regions. If suppose at one instant particle is in delta V1 region, at the same instant it will not be in delta V2 region. And these are mutually exclusive events. Suppose in end trials, particle is found m1 times in delta v1 region and m2 times in delta v2 region. Now, probability of finding particle in region delta v1 is given by p1 is equal to m1 by n. Probability of finding particle in region delta v2 is given by p2 is equal to m2 by n. Now friends, number of times that the particle will be found at least one of the two regions in n trials is m1 plus m2. So probability p of delta v1 or delta v2 is equal to m1 plus m2 upon n plus equal to m1 plus n, m1 upon n plus m2 upon n. So equal to p1 plus p2. This law can be generalized as P is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus dash dash Pn is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n Pi. We will see example. A card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack of 52 cards. Calculate the probability for this card to be either a king or a queen. Friends, you know in pack of cards there are 52 cards. Total number of ways in which event occurs is equal to n is equal to 52. Number of favorable ways of drawing a card, that is queen or queen, we will taking here king first. Probability of drawing a king, m1 is equal to 4, because in pack of 52 cards 4 cards are king. So P1 is equal to M1 by N. So equal to 4 by 52 equal to 1 by 13. Now probability of drawing a queen is P2 is equal to M2 by N. Now we also know there are 4 cards, queen cards. So 4 by 52. So equal to 1 by 13. Now friends, probability that the card is drawn is either a king or queen is given by P is equal to P1 plus P2 is equal to 1 by 13 plus 1 by 13 is equal to 2 by 13. Now we will see second rule of probability theory, multiplication rule of probability. Probability of occurrence of one event does not affect probability of occurrence of other. In first example, in the box of volume V, we have seen probability of occurrence of one event affects probability of occurrence of other event, but in this case it does not affect another event. So from figure A, let us consider that the molecule A gets into volume delta V1, molecule B gets into volume delta V2 at the same instant. We have taken the same figure. in which there are two regions delta v1, delta v2, n particle in both regions. So probability that the molecule gets into delta v1 at particular instant is v1 is equal to delta v1 by v, and probability that a molecule b gets into delta v2 volume at the same instant is v2 is equal to delta v2 by v. Suppose in n trials molecule a is found m on times in delta v1 region, so joint probability of occurrence of these events is given by p is equal to m p2 by n is equal to m by n into p2 is equal to m by n is given by p1, so p1 into p2. Now we will see one example here. We throw a die twice and obtain two numbers. What is the probability that these numbers are 6 and 4 precisely in that order? So probability that first throw gives number 6 is 1 upon 6, and probability that second throw gives number 4 is 1 by 6 also. So required probability is given by 1 by 6 into 1 by 6 is equal to 1 by 36. So probability for event A to occur, the condition that B has occurred is called conditional probability. Now example, an urn contains 4 black and 3 white balls. What is the probability that on two successive draws the balls drawn are both black? There are black balls and white balls, but we have to find two successive draws the balls drawn are both black. So event A, first ball drawn is black, so its probability P of A is 4 by 4 plus 3 is equal to 4 by 7, because there are 4 black balls and total number of balls are 4 plus 3 is 7, so 4 by 7. So event B, second ball drawn is also black, so P of A is equal to 3 upon 3 plus 3 is equal to 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. Now here we have taken total number of balls as 6, because first ball is drawn in first event, and so one ball is less now, so we have taken 6 balls, so 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. The probability of composite event is P of A plus B is equal to P of A into P of B upon A is equal to 4 by 7 into 1 by 2 is 2 by 7. This is the reference I have used to prepare this PowerPoint presentation. I am thankful to this author, Brijlal Subramanian et al. Thank you.